देयरफॉर LHS इक्वल टू इट इज z रेस टू 2n प्लस 2 रेस टू n z रेस टू n प्लस 2 रेस टू 2n. नाउ इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड वी गॉट वैल्यू ऑफ z रेस टू 2n एज 2 रेस टू 2n इनसाइड ब्रैकेट cos ऑफ 4n पाई बाय 3 प्लस I साइन 4n पाई बाय 3 प्लस 2 रेस टू n इज कॉन्स्टेंट विच विल रिमेन सेम देन z रेस टू n. सो इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड वी गॉट वैल्यू ऑफ z रेस टू n एज 2 रेस टू n इनटू cos ऑफ 2n पाई बाय 3 प्लस I साइन 2n पाई बाय 3 नेक्स्ट प्लस 2 रेस टू 2n विच इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट. Now, when we will multiply these two terms, we will get again 2 raised to 2n by law of indices. So, from the first term, second term and third term, we can take 2 raised to 2n common. So, in the next step, we will get remaining terms as it is in the bracket. So, remaining terms are cos of 4n pi by 3 plus I sine 4n pi by 3 plus cos of 2n pi by 3 plus I sin 2n pi by 3 plus 1. Now, the required condition is the answer of this LHS should be equal to 0 if n is not multiple of 3. Now, what is meaning of it is not a multiple of 3? So, let's see. See, whenever n is a multiple of 3, I can say it is equivalent to 3k where k is integer. It means k can take value as 1, 2, 3, 4. So when k is 1, n will give you value as 3. When k is 2, n will give you value as 6. When k is 3, you will get n as 3 into 3, 9. It means every time you are getting multiple of 3, that is 3, 6, 9 and so on. So when we say it is not multiple of 3, it means that number won't come in the table of 3. So, n will be 3k plus 1 or n can be 3k plus 2. So, these are the two possible conditions. So, here we can say n is not multiple of 3, right? So, what we need to prove is when n is 3k plus 1 or n is 3k plus 2, we are getting answer as 0. So, let's start with the first condition. That is, when n is equal to 3k. So, we'll say, if n is multiple of 3, then what happens? And then we'll check, if n is not multiple of 3, then what happens? So, when n is equal to 3k, we will get LHS equal to 2 raised to 6k. Next, it is cos of 4, n is 3k, so 12 pi by 3 plus I sin 12 pi by 3 plus cos, here n is 3k, so 6k pi by 3. So, when n is equal to 3k plus 1, that time LHS is equal to 2 raised to 2n. So, it will become 2 into n. N is 3k plus 1. Similarly, inside bracket we will get cos of 4n pi. N is 3k plus 1 pi by 3 plus I sin 4 3k plus 1 again pi by 3. Plus cos 2 into 3k plus 1 pi by 3 plus I sin 2 into 3k plus 1 pi by 3 plus 1. So, I have substituted n equal to 3k plus 1 in the LHS and now Let's solve it and we'll check whether we are getting 0 or not. So, here it will become 2 raised to 6k plus 2. Next, here we will get cos of, now see, 4 pi into 3k will give me 12k pi. Next, 4 pi into 1 is 4 pi, whole divided by 3. Plus, I sine 4 pi into 3k is 12k pi plus 4 pi by 3. Plus, cos of 2 pi into 3k is 6k pi and 2 pi into 1 is 2 pi by 3. Plus, I sine 2 pi into 3k is 6k pi plus 2 pi by 3 plus 1. Now, we will find the answer of these terms, that is cos, sine and these two cosine, sine. So, it will become 2 raised to 6k plus 2 inside bracket. Now, we will divide separately by 3. So, we will get cos of 4k pi plus 4 pi by 3 plus I sine 4k pi plus 4 pi by 3 plus cos of, here we will get 6k pi upon 3, that is 2k pi plus 2 pi by 3 plus I sine 2k pi plus 2 pi by 3 plus 1. Now, next step, we will simplify this using the formula cos A plus B. And here we will apply the formula sin A plus B. Now, we all know that cos of A plus B is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So, I'll apply that formula over here. And here I'll apply sin A cos B plus cos A sin B for this sin A plus B. So, we will get 2 raised to 6k plus 2 into, now what is this? It will become cos of 4k pi into cos of 4 pi by 3 minus sin of 4k pi into sin of 4 pi by 3. Similarly, this will become sin of 4k pi into cos of 4 pi by 3 plus cos of 4k pi into sin of 4 pi by 3. Now, previous term was cos 2k pi plus 2 pi by 3. So, I'll apply formula for this and then for this. So, angles are 2k pi and 2 pi by 3. So, it will become plus cos 2k pi into cos 2 pi by 3 plus, sorry, it is minus because the formula of cos A plus B is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, sin 2k pi into sin 2 pi by 3. Plus I, it will become sin 2k pi into cos 2 pi by 3 plus cos 2k pi into sin 2 pi by 3. And the last term was plus 1. Now, let's see what will be the